Hi, I'm back again. It's Debbie Bridge, and I'm here with another Odes to Joy overseas with Eric Webster. He's come all the way from Michigan to tell us his Odes to Joy. Eric.
Thanks for having me. I think this is just a delightful project and so needed in a time of, at least here in the U.S., so much controversy and that's where I'll leave that so we don't get out of the joyful track. So for me, you mentioned when we talked a few minutes ago about the basis of this being Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, the Ode to Joy. And so incredible music of, gosh, any stripe will take me to that joyous place. No work better than Beethoven's Ninth. It's one that brings tears to my eyes. Just even thinking about it right now, I'm starting to well up a little bit because it is just such a masterwork. But a beautiful soprano soprano doesn't have to be beautiful, but her voice does, singing an operatic aria or anything like that. Just, you know, one of my favorite things is a glass of wine, a cigar, playlist in my earbuds, watching the, I live on a farm, so we have horses and donkeys and goats and deer and foxes, and you know, you never know who's going to come by. But just watching the beauty, taking time to notice that the creation that we have been blessed to live within is about so much more than, pardon my language, politics and bullshit. If we allow ourselves the space and the grace to be an actual participant and observer. And I guess probably those are the things that most light me up. Of course, I have a son and a daughter that are adults, and so their lives and my daughter's stepkids and all of the fun stuff of that. And I'm married, and so, you know, the marriage stuff. But at my core, the stuff that really brings me back to who I believe myself to be, who I want to be in the world. It's about taking that minute, taking that breath, and really appreciating a sunrise, a sunset, the turf war of the hummingbirds at the feeder. All of that sort of natural, delightful, that it's so easy to miss if you just are all in your head and worried about what's next. So I guess that's the short answer. And with the last name of Webster, I get my words wholesale, so I tend to overuse them a lot. So we'll call that good.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Eric, for joining us and to do this. I think you're one of the few Americans I've actually had do one of these, so I'm really glad that you got on board.
Well, you know, joy is possible even in America in 2020.
Yes, it is possible.